Hey everybody, this is Glidercat, and it's time to play. We're back in Trappist. Let's get back to it. Between episodes, I started thawing out a few more colonists. What I want to do this episode is get our 60 colonists onto Haven and put as many of them to work as we can. Right now we're producing concrete. Let's see how many we need to bring over there. I want to get there. I want to make sure I don't take my shuttle. Boom. We've got 23. We need to get to 60. So we need, 37, right? 37? Whoops, back to space. We need 37 colonists. We'll keep thawing them out. These two cryopods are now empty, and I've got, how many do I have on the ship so far? 20. So we need 17 more. We'll let those thaw, and then we get a new report from our Planet X survey. That's the main planet. We surveyed two of the moons of that planet last episode. Let's see what it says. Planet X is a small gas giant. It's so cute. I'm sure someday we'll have the technology to uncover its mysteries and resources. Unfortunately, not today. Okay, looks like we're not going to be able to do anything with that one, but let's read the report. The small gas giant has large amounts of valuable materials. Due to its relatively small size, this gas giant is unusually hospitable. With the right technologies, we'll be able to construct floating platforms to mine valuable gases from within the lower layers of the atmosphere. So that sounds cool, but it sounds like we might need to unlock some stuff before we can explore that planet. So let's click that. And let's get our cargo ship out here. Where are you? Should be an icon. Yeah, there is. It's behind me. Let's get this guy exploring some new place. Yeah, we can't even land on the planet like we could for these unexplored sites. Actually, before we go, let's land here again and put down our colony hub and our landing pad. And then this guy will have a name. It won't just be unexplored. Yeah, this has got bumpy terrain here. Oh, man. Yeah, the terrain looks pretty rocky. I wonder if we can build on these rocks. There's a flat spot here and a flat spot here. Let's do right here. Put down our colony. Oh, what? They're not going to let me. Oh, that's the edge of the map, but that's as far as I can put the colony hub. Interesting. Yeah, it's not letting me put it any further over. Well, what does that mean? Where should I be placing this? I'm going to put it right here, and then whatever happens, happens. We'll figure it out. Plunk this guy down. Boom. Surface is covered with helium-3 rich regolith. That's what we need for our fusion reactors. Okay, good. And what is this place called? The Dig. Now I can send this shuttle back to space. I want him or her, go explore another planet in our system while we're doing other things. About kind of try and hit the outer rings first. Let's do this one, Jungle Planet. And we gotta get back to the Ark. Gonna check this one more time. We need 37 more people. We've got 32, we need 5 more, then we can stop the thawing process. Whoops, what's going on there? Boom. I think that's it. Set the camera here on the Ark. We need 37. One more. Boom. Okay, that's perfect. And I said we were going to borrow the concrete, I think. Let's do that for now. And they have plenty of water down on the surface. Let's get down to Haven and continue building out that colony. We're bringing a ton of people down, a little bit of concrete to help us build the habitats. And then hopefully this colony will be a source of concrete for us long term. We know we're going to need habitats. Each one of these holds 8. So that's what, 24. Need 4 more, I think. One, 2, 3, 4. Let's see where that puts us in terms of our housing. 56 habitats. We need one more, I guess. We want to get up to 60 people. Boom. And now we can unload all the folks. Boom. So now we've got 60. We just met the objective. Great. With more colonists, we can build and support more advanced buildings. Keep in mind that colonists living in larger colonies demand more varied resources. They can demand all they want. Doesn't mean they're going to get them. Let's unload the concrete. I'm just kidding, by the way. We have on this planet a bunch of silicon. Look at that, 23 silicon. Let's go. Let's build this planet out a bit more and then see what we want to do. Concrete, in terms of their sand, let's see if we're supplying enough to keep our existing concrete factory and our silicon smelter here busy enough. This concrete factory wants 4 sand a minute. This guy wants 4 sand a minute. We need 8 sand per minute. And we're currently producing 6, right? 2, 4, 6. So we need one more sand pit at least. One more sand pit to keep our existing, our single concrete factory and silicon factory going. Let's do that, and then we'll look at these messages here in a second. Resources, sand pit. I think I can squeeze it in here and still benefit from the drones. Boom. All right. Underground oil reservoir. I guess we got to start from down. Can I scroll these? I can't. Okay, the jungle planet is completely covered in a purple jungle. We spotted small campfires and other signs of civilization. We'll need to keep our distance until we can be sure not to endanger the native population. Okay, let's look at the report. A clearly life-bearing planet, damp and covered in a deep purple jungle. Within the deep jungle, there are a few clearings to build a foothold for our explorations. The fires visible at night could indicate intelligent life. We should try to limit our interference on this planet for now. All right. Interesting. We'll dismiss that. And it says, we found an underground oil reservoir at a second site on the desert planet. That's where we're at now. Oil will be very useful for energy and plastics. All right. Let's finish working on Haven, though, before we do more exploring. I wanted to check the food levels. We have 60 people down here. Now we need 2 food per minute. And we are producing, I think, exactly that. Oh, no, we're still producing 4 potatoes a minute. That's awesome. In fact, let's load up our cargo ship with potatoes, one of our cargo holds. I'm going to take these back to the station. And we may need to supply food to another place. But these guys are running in surplus, so I'm going to take it. Water. Oh, I thought we'd have more water by now. Let's see what the water usage is. Water, the people want 2 per minute. Concrete factory wants 2 per minute, right? So that's 4 per minute. And I think these are each putting out 2 per minute. Yeah, 2 per minute. Yeah, our colonists are running out of supplies. It might be because I took all their potatoes. I think that's going to self-correct. But I do think we should put down another water pump. Because we saw, I think one of the other sites is going to need water. So it'd be nice for these guys to produce a surplus. Let's do it. If we have the building materials. 4 steel beams. Oh, man. Steel beams are hard to come by. Boom. I'm going to go ahead and tear down this extra turbine that we've got. And make use of that steel. We have a deficit on power, but we have tons of silicon here. So let's build some solar panels for power. Get at least another couple down. Okay, that puts us in a nice surplus for now. What else? Let's look at the factories that we can build. Oh, research lab. Okay, explore strange new worlds and seek out new technologies to improve efficiencies. And there's a little quote here. This compact data center is a great support to any enterprising away team. That needs 4 computer chips. Whoa, look at the energy cost. 12 energy. I think that might be worth doing, though. We've got some new other buildings we can do, too. Grain mill, bakery, rocket fuel refinery, ship fabricator. Takes 20 energy. 2 computer chips. These all sound kind of compelling. Not so worried about the advanced food. Do our colonists, are they complaining about that? Yeah. So they're not super happy. They want these extra tier 2 products that we're not making yet. Kind of want to get steel going before we do that. So I'm going to steal all this silicon. 24, that's enough for... but 6 solar panels. Potatoes are replenished. Their water should be climbing. I may actually steal some water. 10 water. And we're going to bring that back up to the station. And we're going to leave this site be for a bit. They got plenty of power. A bunch of extra workers. Wondering, should we do another sand pit before we go? Just to put the workers to work. We've got extra energy. We've got colonists and we've got concrete. Do it. Can't get those up here, unfortunately. There it goes. Good. That'll go. That'll get us just a surplus of sand. It'll keep people working. Potatoes, I don't think we need more of. Tempted to do more water. 4 steel beams. We have 10. You know what? We can always recover the steel. So let's, we have the workers, we have the energy. Let's pump a bit more water. And then we can, take more later, maybe. From these guys. What do they have? They have 6 now. I'm going to steal a little bit more and take it with us. In fact, I'm going to take all of it. Let's go back up to the, to the Ark. We got water, we got silicon, we got potatoes. I'm going to unload the potatoes. What we really need is concrete. That's going to go back down to Haven because we're going to go check out this unexplored site. This is where they said they've discovered oil. But I need some kind of building materials before we can do that. In fact, I'll give up the water. I'm going to go back down to Haven and see if they have any concrete I can steal. It might. We brought some down. Our other cargo ship is just orbiting a planet right now, not really doing anything. We'll set that guy out to do some more exploring or surveying for us in a minute, but we got our hands full right now. I'm going to steal all the concrete. And we're going to head over back up to space. We're going to head over to this unexplored site on our desert planet. Hopefully our shuttle will make its way there. Here it comes. Boom. Let's do it. Let's just build here. It looks like we got a big open space. Kind of like that. Our hub. And they're going to give us a landing pad. Boom. Bring our cargo ship over to the landing pad so we can unload the resources. As this site is much less hospitable than Haven, we'll have to move water and food to this site if anyone is to live here. Oh, man. And food? Let's see what it says about this site. It's called Graveyard. It's got Earth gravity. It has oxygen. That's all good. It has CO2, so we should be able to do plants. I wonder why we can't grow food. Sand. So we can make concrete if we want here. And then crude oil. All right, let's got building materials. Let's do some building. I don't have any colonists on the cargo ship, but we know we're going to need pioneer camps. Let's put down three of these right out. Or let's put two of these down to get us started. Shift. Do I not have? Oh, I got to unload the concrete. Boom. And I'm going to unload the silicon. Now we can put down those pioneer camps, two of them. One and two. That way we'll have a home for our people once we bring them down. What can we build? Can we? Oh, whoops, I didn't mean to do that, but that's all right. He's going back into space. Can we not build food? Potato farm. Doesn't take water. No. It shows crops there, crop icon. Let's build a potato farm. I think we can. I think we can do it. Boom. We're not going to be able to build a thing for water. We can build soybeans here, but I kind of want to keep this colony, maybe keep it small, since we have to import water just to keep them alive. It says water pump. If I click it, it's going to tell me water's not available here. I can't do that. Oil's a cheap way to power our colonies and grow the algae to feed our crew. We can use it to make plastics. Fresh air from an oxygen bottling plant would be much appreciated by all those still in space. Do we have the ability to do that? Utilities, resources, oxygen bottling plant. Yeah, I bet we can do that over in Haven. So I'm going to wait, do it over there. Here, though. Under utilities, let's get some power generation going. We brought all that silicon. I'm going to put down a few of these guys. Just to get us started on power. Okay, to construct these buildings, we'll need more steel beams. We already located a source of iron on the first moon planet. Or we can recycle the empty cryopods. All right. Yeah, we do need more steel. What else do we need to get this going? We only need two colonists to run this colony, but let's build out some stuff here. They want us to build an oil jack, so that's probably resources, oil. It looks like the water pump a little tiny bit. I desperately need the steel now. Let's go back to the Ark. I think we have some still on here. We've got 34 steel beams. Let's just take 10 and let's thaw out some colonists and bring these guys down. I don't know how many to bring down. Maybe 8 or so? 8 or 9? 10? We'll send 10 down. And then we know these guys need water, right? So let's take all the water. I don't know if the people here need water. Let's take a bit of water. We'll take 36 water down to them as well. Get them started. 7. Waiting for more colonists to thaw. Oh, that cryopod is empty. Another one melting. We could harvest these for steel. 8, 9, 10. Let's do that. Put 10 colonists on here. Let's stick the camera on the Ark for a second. So they're saying we could harvest these for these cryopods for steel. But these actually have another mode where you can refreeze colonists. So if you look at the bottom, it says left at the bottom of the pop-up, it says left click to switch this pod to freeze colonists. So that'd be cool if we can grow colonists on the planet or the planets and then eventually maybe refreeze them and go somewhere else. That would be kind of cool. Can we build those? See what we can build here. Oh, we can build cryopods. So yeah, if we want steel beams, we can leverage these and later on we can always build them back up. I think we get everything back, right? Okay, destroying the selected building is going to get us 8 concrete, 8 steel beams, and 4 water. Let's see what it costs to build one. 8 concrete, 8 steel beams, and 4 water. So that's a no-brainer, right? Once these are empty, which all of these are, let's deconstruct these. And we can make use of that steel on these planets that we're colonizing. Yeah, that's awesome. So now I can take maybe 20 steel. I'm pausing, kind of hesitating because we have this graveyard site that we want to get built out, but I also really want to get over to that iron planet. But let's do graveyard and then we'll do the iron moon and see if we can get that going. Okay, here they want us to build that oil jack, so let's unload everything. Boom. Okay, the geysers, these geysers in Haven, that's our other colony, are not just a water source for the colony. They are a source of information on how evolution and geology interacted on this planet. Take a closer look to collect samples that can be used for research. Okay. Our colonists on graveyard are running out of supplies. Okay, of course they are. What are they running out of? We are able to produce potatoes. That's what they're out of, though. I think we're going to start getting potatoes. There we go. These guys should be okay on food. They're not going to be okay on water for real long. We brought some over. Got 35 water right now. But now let's get to the objectives. They want us to do oil. Let's put at least one of these little pump jack guys down. And then we need in factories. Here's a plastic factory. That says it takes refined oil. Here's the refinery. Okay, refines crude oil into usable oil. Let's put that down somewhere. Boom. Okay, we're going to need to bring more workers down, but power's looking good. And let's see what these guys produce. This one kicks out 2 crude oil a minute. This guy wants, 8 crude oil a minute. Let's put down at least one more pump jack. We don't have to max out production necessarily, at least not this early on. But we probably need at least 2. Okay, so that should get us refined oil. And then if we want to turn that into plastics, we need this factory. 8 concrete and 4 steel beams. Man, that's a biggie. I guess we could push it up way up here. Might work if we do it right there. Let's try it. We'll learn together whether that's going to work or not. Looks like it's shaded, right? Just curious if our drones are going to be able to deliver to this thing. I think so. We'll find out. These guys are harvesting oil. So we've got 4 crude oil in storage. Hopefully they'll bring it here, but they might not. Oh, well, they need the refined oil. Do we have any of that? Not yet. Our refinery is still waiting on 8 units of crude oil before it gets started. Oh, and he's waiting on colonists. Yeah, we're going to have to go get 12 more colonists back to the ark. These guys starting to thaw. We'll see if we can't get graveyard, that little colony, up and running. And then we'll have to make a trip over to, or then we can move over to that moon and start processing iron. Okay, what do we need? Like 12? Graveyard. We are, yeah, 12 short. There we go. We got 12 colonists. Pause these guys. Load them onto the cargo ship. Could take a few extra, but let's take a couple more. Maybe four more. Maybe that'll save us a trip up here. Yeah, 16 colonists can go down. What else? These guys need water. We have 33. I'm going to take 20 while I'm heading down there. And I'm going to put iron on the ship. We may or may not drop this off. If we need it, we'll use it. If we don't, we won't bother. Back down to graveyard. Boink. Unload the people. Oh, we're going to need more habitats, right? So we're going to have 20. Let's see. Unload these guys. I need room for 10 more. So two more of these buildings. Abilities, pioneer camps. We'll get two more of these put down. Boom. Now I can unload my colonists. Boink. Give these guys more water, fill up their tanks. And what else do we need? Tempted to do one more pump jack. Let's see. We've got refining. We've got plastics production. What else? Anything in the objectives they want us to do? Oh, build an oxygen bottling plant and supply it with plastic. So that's where the plastic's going to get used. We could try and put that down here. Was hoping not to make this colony super big. Short on concrete. But we do have the workers. I'd have to go get some concrete. And we're short on energy, but these guys have enough energy. Let's build another solar panel. I guess we should get to producing oxygen. Oh, good. This one's not real big. Maybe we can tuck this in down here. Well, they're not going to let me build it till we get the concrete. All right, if you insist. These guys have 4 steel beams. I'm going to leave them with 8. And yeah, let's go over to Haven and get some concrete. Hopefully they've got a bunch waiting for us. We'll send this guy back up into space and down to Haven. I think later on we're going to be able to set up automatic trade routes. I haven't done it yet, but it seems like that's something I think we can do. I'm going to take all your concrete. I'm going to take all your water, since you guys are producing that in surplus. I don't have room for anything else. I could leave you with some more beams. I'll leave you with a couple beams. And yeah, I can't really take anything else, so let's head out. Boy, they've got 34 silicon. Oh, you know what we should do? You know what we should do? We should be making solar panels with this just from an inventory standpoint, even if they don't need the power. If we make solar panels, we can always deconstruct them later. Let's do that just so they can keep producing silicon for us without the inventory backing things up, storage space. So I'm going to put down a bunch of these with the plan later on to eventually pull these up and harvest that silicon back from. I don't think there's any cost. Yeah, it's just energy. Yeah, now they've got room to store a bunch more silicon. In fact, we might as well do two more. Don't know if there's a reason not to do this. There might be some building limit or something, but we'll cross that bridge if we encounter that. All right, so we are loaded up. I'm going to steal a little bit more concrete. Water's loaded, and we've got some steel. We got to head back to graveyard. Hopefully our guy's on his way. Nope, I didn't have him selected. I think if I, let's just test something out. If I select the cargo ship, and without saying go to space, if I go back to this view and then right click on graveyard. Yeah, he's going to come. Get a little pathfinding. We just want to get the oxygen bottling plant up and running over here and do it. That required the concrete, right? So let's give these guys any concrete to start. Resources, oxygen bottling plant. Oh yeah, this guy's a little dinky guy. Boom, right there. That's going to take plastic from our plastics plant. We're not really optimized yet with just two of these pump jacks going. We'd get a third one down. Can't get another pump jack down without getting people. So this, let's let this run. Okay, fresh air, as long as we have enough plastic coming in. All right. While we're down here, my water's already full, so I can't take that. I will take the concrete that you guys have available. Let's take these resources over to that moon. I'm going to let this guy go back up into space. We have an objective to build an algae farm and do some research stuff, but I want to find that moon that's got the resources we need, steel. I think that was, which one was it? The Dig or Outland? We could look here. Outland, yeah, it looks like iron on Outland. Let's do, that's where we want to go. Boom, moved to Outland. While we're waiting for that guy to make the trip, we can grab our other shuttle. And it looks like we can't even settle on Jungle Planet yet. Let's go look for another guy to explore. How about this thing right here? Boom. That guy starts surveying. And a bunch more planets to survey. It says on the ARC they want us to build an algae farm. I guess we could look at that while we're waiting for ships to move around. We may not have the building resources to do it. Extract. There it is. Algae farm. We have what we need. Let's do it. Boom. And we need to thaw two colonists for this. So do that. One, two. Okay, Soylent is what us spacemen are made of. Yeah, thanks. That might be a reference to Soylent Green and movie. Really old movie. We now have our basic supplies covered to really expand our colonies. We require more rare materials. We might find those by surveying other planets in the TRAPPIST solar system. Let's see what's out there. Hey, that's what I've been doing. All right, these guys, this algae plant is going to want crude oil, and we're kind of anemic producing that. It wants water and crude oil, so we are going to have to increase our production on graveyard at some point, because all of that refined oil, or all the crude is being turned into refined oil, all the refined oil is being turned into plastic, and all our plastic is being turned into oxygen bottles, so we have some work to do. Get the algae farm actually up and running. Let's go see if we landed on the iron Iron Moon. Yeah, here we are. Let's see what we can do here. Did I bring colonists? I did not. We're going to have to make a... Oh, not what I meant to do. Go back to Outland. Sorry about that. Let's see what we can build here. Ice grinder. Extracts ice. Every minute this building produces 2 ice gravel. We can unload these. We didn't need to bring water here. Yeah, we've got the ice. I'm going to unload the concrete and the steel beams. Now let's see what we can build again. We know we're going to need iron mine for sure. Let's get that placed. Oh, it's nice and small. Happy about that. We're going to have to bring some silicon over here so we can put solar panels down. You know, stop over at Haven to pick that up. All right, Zima's surface is completely frozen. Under the ice is a liquid ocean. We picked up some interesting readings in a nearby spot where the ice is not too thick. Okay, this is the planet we just surveyed. Let's go read the report. This planet is within the Goldilocks zone, but covered with a thick crust of ice. Under the ice is a single planet-spanning ocean. This ocean has a mostly agreeable temperature, and anything could be hidden in the darkness under the ice. The initial survey located a hot spot within the ocean. This hot spot is a source of radiation, and the water surrounding it is noticeably warmer. The ice crust above this area is not as thick as elsewhere. We should be able to drill through and explore the ocean from there. That sounds kind of cool. We'll have to make our way over there. Let's get down. All right, let's finish doing a little building here, then we'll call it an episode. What else can we actually build? Water splitter. Water is necessary, but so is oxygen and fuel. Every minute, this building uses 6 water, and it produces 2 oxygen and 4 hydrogen. Do we have oxygen here? No. It's like gravity, most... Okay, vacuum. Gonna bring oxygen. We do have water and we have iron. Our colonists at Graveyard will need regular deliveries of water and potatoes. Even if I get tired of making the same deliveries over and over again, how do we automate this? Yeah, this is I'm curious about. Click the return to space zoom out button in the lower left corner. The first click will take you to the solar system view. A second click will zoom out. Once zoomed out, select a cargo ship. Oh, and click the trade route button next to, oh man, I can't read fast enough. Add 2 or more trade stops by clicking the plus button to the next colony mark. Use right click on any of the 3 cargo bays under the trade stop to select a resource. Use left click on a cargo bay to select the amount. The ship will be attempted to load. We can read this later right there. Read me trade routes. Once set up, the cargo ship will just make its deliveries. Just keep an eye on the resources. Okay, interesting. You only got 2 cargo ships, though. We'll research that later. Not this episode. I want to see what else we could build. Hydrogen liquefier, iron smelter. Interested in that. Very interested in that. Let's put this guy down. And see what these consume. This one wants 4 iron a minute. This guy produces 2 iron ore a minute. Let's see if we can build another iron mine. Will they let me build it? Yeah, I got the concrete, so I should be able to at least build it. I can squeeze it down here. Hopefully that'll work. We'll see. Those are balanced out. Can I do potatoes? Vacuum. I don't see any plants growing up here. Utilities, factories. Yeah, I don't see an option for food. Helium harvester, iron mines, ice grinders. Definitely need that. Every minute this building produces 2 ice gravel. We're going to need that ice grinder. And is there somewhere to melt it? Here it is. Ice melter. Every minute it uses 4 gravel and produces 2 water. Got the resources. Let's get that down. We're going to need 16 workers. We're going to need a whole bunch of silicon to make solar panels. Algae farm, water, and crude oil. We only need the algae, I think, to make the health drinks. And we only need the health drinks once the population gets really big. Ice grinder. Iron mine. Helium harvester later. Water splitter later. Hydrogen liquefier later. This produces rocket fuel. Iron smelter we have. Ice melter we have. Ice grinder we've got. Iron mine we've got. Fusion reactor. Nearly unlimited power from basic elements. Interesting. Ooh, 12 plasteel bricks. We don't know how to make those. We do know how to make computer chips. We should be doing that over on Haven. We're going to have to expand Haven once we get some more steel. Research lab, we'll do that on Haven. Shipyard, haven't explored this yet. I'm guessing this is going to allow us to have more cargo ships, and then we can run more trade routes once we get to doing that. Cryopods. Interesting. Yeah, I wonder why you'd want to do, you could possibly do cryopods down on the surface of a planet and thaw them out when you need them. That would be kind of interesting. Automated depot. Yeah, we'll do that later too. Tell you what, let's call this episode here. Next episode, we're going to run back to the Ark, pick up at least 16 people, probably grab like 20 or 24. And then we also need to make a stop at Haven and pick up silicon. If they've got enough in their inventory, we'll just grab it. If we need more, we can deconstruct those solar panels we put down and get more, but we probably want a full load over here. These guys need 36 power, and these guys only put out 6. So we need enough for 6. We need at least 24 silicon. We can easily get that, I think. And then, yeah, we'll pick it up from there. For now, this is GliderCat saying thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoy this Let's Play on Trappist. Oh, man, this is a cool game. I really like this game. And the longer you play, the more of the game systems kind of reveal themselves. We just saw the details on the trade routes. I'm anxious to set those up. But that's it for now. I want to thank GliderCat patrons and channel members for their support. Deeply, deeply appreciate it. If you'd like to help contribute to the GliderCat channel, keep it running, you can hit that thanks button or look at the links in the description and you can sign up to become a channel member or a patron. I would deeply appreciate the support. And with that, I'll see you all in the next episode.